sometimes that the second generation that in daily life they can communicate with their parents in their home language, but when they have to talk about the feelings, more in-depth, more sensitive issues, the second generation sometimes find that they don't have that wording. They don't know how to phrase it, or even with some how to translate the whole message about, say, the having a bad news or disease progress. So sometimes that they have difficulty to translate this kind of the topic. On one hand is the children themselves have difficulty to process that bad news. On the other hand, also find a suitable wording to translate is also a challenge for themselves. So sometimes the children will come to me and then to see how to support the patients. Yeah, and then the other thing is the children sometimes they don't know, for example, when they see their patients, their parents, that they don't talk much. They don't go to support group. They don't like us that we will cry and talk with our friends. So how can we support the parents like that? So in that sense that maybe we can, I will talk with the children about that. Yeah, sometimes that they need the time. Sometimes that maybe you can share with them your own feeling first and then to make them feel more comfortable. And sometimes that they don't say it out, but doesn't mean that they don't have feelings. Maybe they just use other ways. For example, that if you can have a dinner with them, they already feel the support and care from you rather than they have to say that, oh, I'm upset, I'm depressed, like that. Sometimes that kind of the support act, help them to get their close friend to visit them is also very important. So some of the way is to help the second generations know about how to best support their parents.